let's start with what happened yesterday. How did you, who were you tweeting this to, and what has it turned into? Because I read it and I thought, oh my gosh, this is great.
So my tweet yesterday was exactly what you said. If we are saying that young children or even teenagers are, that they have the capacity to consent to a sex change, to hormone blockers, to all of these things that we say are necessary for gender transformation at a young age, why don't they also have the capacity to consent to a relationship with an older person? Or like you posed, a young child, why not? What logically is actually stopping that? And of course, the leftist blue check marks came out in droves saying that this is a ridiculous connection, that this is the slippery slope fallacy. But of course, they couldn't actually answer the question. Right. They couldn't say why logically that is different. I knew that my mentions were going to go up in flames, but I think it's a reasonable question to ask, and I never got an answer to it.
Because you're just saying one is a really important decision. So if you have the capacity to make one really important decision, why wouldn't you have the capacity to make another important decision?
Because there is no other reason. We say consenting adults.
Right.
So if it's consent and you don't have to be an adult to make game-changing decisions, then what really, and I'm not saying this slippery slope, I'm saying let's just be consistent.
Exactly. And that's a really good point, is really when it comes to sexual morality for most progressives or most people on the left, the only lines of morality that are drawn are autonomy and consent. So I'm just saying, if those are the only lines of morality that are drawn when it comes to sexuality, what's stopping a child who apparently has autonomy and consent from exercising that autonomy and consent when it comes to having an older relationship? So the argument really is that maybe there are other lines of morality that we should draw outside of autonomy and consent. Maybe there are other things that we should consider.
So who came after you yesterday?
Oh, I don't even know who they are. Okay. Well, I knew when Ben Shapiro retweeted me that they were going to come out. It kind of flew under the radar for a little bit until the power of Ben Shapiro came.
So
it's a blessing and a curse on that one, because every once in a while he'll retweet something that I do, and then it's just like I've got my entire mentions for the next 2 days is just nonstop.
Ben's haters are intense.
Yes, they are.